Neuroscientist Dr. Jacobo Grinberg Zilberbaum worked extensively with shamans and other individuals in Mexico, collecting vast amounts of data using electroencephalograph readings and various inventories relevant to learning, memory, perception, and biopsychology. One of these studies began by having two people meditate together for 20 minutes. They were then separated into different rooms, both of which were shielded from all electromagnetic energies. One person was presented with random flashes of light designed to elicit shock responses. The other person, sitting in a different room, was hooked up to an EEG machine. The subject's EEG readings showed a similar shock response, perfectly timed with the other individual's light flashes 25% of the time. A control group, on the other hand, showed no such correlation. Many interesting variations of this study were conducted, all with equally interesting results. Grinberg published these results in Physics Essays, a highly respected peer-reviewed journal. And though this evidence was painstakingly collected in more than 50 experiments over a 5-year period, he received a great deal of criticism. In yet another paper, he expressed his theory of a pre-space structure he referred to as a holographic non-local lattice, a matrix, if you will. In this promising but controversial paper, Grinberg attributed nothing less than consciousness to this matrix, stating that the neuronal field emanating from the brain distorts this lattice and activates a partial interpretation of it that is perceived as an image. Only when the brain-mind system is free from interpretations do the neuronal field and the pre-space structure become identical. He concluded that all individual minds were linked to one another via this non-local matrix. Subsequent studies conducted by other researchers seem to validate Grinberg's original findings. Physicist Fred H. Theyheld, for instance, used Faraday cages to shield two separate compartments from electromagnetic energies. One person was hooked up to an EEG in one chamber, and another person was likewise attached to an EEG in the other chamber. The compartments were isolated from one another, making impossible any means of communication. Yet, when one subject was presented with stimulating visual patterns, there was a statistically significant response rate in which the other subject's EEG showed a corresponding and simultaneous response. Charles Tart of UC Davis conducted a similar experiment, but instead of using an EEG and visual stimulation, he monitored galvanic skin resistance, or GSR, blood volume, and heart rate in response to small electric shocks. Two people were asked to meet one another and agree to remaining connected after going their separate ways. When isolated in different rooms, Tart administered small electric shocks to the sender. Even though the receiver was totally unaware of any response at all, Tart's data revealed that the receiver's GSR, blood volume, and heart rate all indeed reacted to each of the sender's shocks. The power of intention. Transpersonal psychologists and researchers Marilyn Schlitz and William Broud supplied even more evidence for the theory of a non-local connecting field in a study that seemed to confirm the influence of distant intentionality. Subjects were attached to a computer measuring skin resistance. An influencer would be placed in a separate room and asked to influence the receiver to either calm down or become agitated during 30 10-second intervals randomly picked. During these randomly chosen intervals, the influencer would enter the desired state and project it towards the receiver, who could not be seen or communicated with in any way. Even though the receivers had no idea when the influencers were focusing on them, their skin response showed a direct correlation with the influencer's intentions 57% of the time. Gene Achterberg, PhD, had 11 experienced healers send healing intentions at randomly chosen and uneven intervals to completely isolated receivers whose brains were monitored using MRI scans. Even though these receivers were entirely unaware of when these distant intentions were being sent, 9 out of 11 of them had MRI scans showing distinct and perfectly timed responses to these intentions. long-distance brainwave entrainment. Italian researcher Dr. Natamo Montecuccio demonstrated long-distance brainwave entrainment between two groups of meditators. Two groups of meditators, one in Tuscany and the other in Milan, meditated with the intention of connecting with each other. The resulting brainwave analysis showed a statistically significant brainwave synchronization between the two groups. Dream influence. Over a period of 5 years, Stanley Krippner and Associates conducted 62 experiments in which sleeping receivers apparently had dreams directly shaped by influencers in a separate room. Before going to sleep, the receiver would meet the influencer and both of them would discuss the intention to connect while the sleeper was dreaming. After the receiver went to sleep, the influencer would randomly choose one of several envelopes, which contained different images, and enter into a separate room to sit quietly, open the envelope, and focus on the image. Because the sleeper's brain activity and eye movements were monitored, researchers could tell when the receiver was experiencing REM sleep, the period in which dreaming takes place. As soon as the REM sleep ended, the receiver would be awakened and asked about the dream. Results from 5 years of study revealed that a statistically significant amount of the receivers had dreams correlated with images sent by the influencers. An invisible data bank. These and other studies seem to point to a non-local field simultaneously transcending and supporting time and space that mediates otherwise unexplainable and instantaneous long-distance communication. While these studies do not offer conclusive proof of such a field, when combined with further studies we'll explore later, they strongly suggest the existence of a kind of universal matrix, which facilitates material existence through an invisible flow of energy and information. The EPR experiment. The pre-space non-local lattice Grinberg referred to in his most well-known paper relates to an even more well-known thought experiment set forth in 1935 by Albert Einstein and contemporaries Boris Podolsky and Nathan Rosen. The EPR experiment was designed to disprove theoretical physicist Werner Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, which essentially states that specific pairs of variables, such as the motion and location of a particle, cannot be simultaneously observed. The experiment creates a singlet state between two particles, in which the spin of one particle cancels the spin of the other. In this experimental design, after separating the two particles by a considerable distance, the spins of both particles are measured simultaneously, demonstrating that the location and motion of a particle can both be observed at the same time. Because of the technological limitations present in 1935, the EPR experiment could only be conducted in the imagination. With the rise of new technological innovations, however, not only were similar experiments later successfully performed, they exhibited a strange and instantaneous long-distance connection between particles that, according to the theories of the time, should not be possible. When the spin of one particle was measured, it was found that the spin of the other particle would be exactly opposite. Yet, in terms of the previously mentioned singlet state, this canceling spin should only occur when the two particles are in proximity of one another. Even stranger, not only did this canceling action take place when the particles were distantly separated, the measurement of one particle appeared to cause the other particle to adjust its spin accordingly. Possibly even more amazing, in the case of French physicist Alain Aspect's experiment, this long-distance communication took place roughly 20 times faster than the speed of light, and according to Einstein, the speed of light is supposed to be unsurpassable. An experiment conducted by Dr. Nicholas Gissen established even faster communication, approximately 20,000 times faster than the speed of light. A non-local connecting dimension. The studies thus far mentioned, in addition to many more studies not mentioned here, help us to conceive Grinberg's pre-space structure as a dimension that connects all things in time and space in a single instant, a metaspace that contains time and space and ultimately transcends them.